About the game, what I talked about on the night of the opening is just sort of the symbology that fed into it. And I didn't really talk about too much about my intentions with it because I really like to see what other people think about it. But as Chris was asking, you probably recognize the number of meetings of Alessandro Bonicelli in the background. And this is a two-scale level. It's actually about twice the size of real life, if anybody's seen it in Florence. It's in the Uffizi Gallery. And it's larger room, it's behind glass, and it's just really beautiful, really dominates the room. And if I had the ability to transport it, I would have done a two-scale replica. But I wanted to keep the mirror, the Virgin life size in it. I wanted to have her sort of floating in the pose, coming down. The word deposition is where I took the title's reposition the Virgin. I was doing a play on the word deposition. Deposition refers to when Christ is coming down off of the cross. And he's usually very tranquil, languid, held by other figures because he's dead at this point. And it's after the torment gets longer. But I wanted, since I had some figures in the background with Botticelli painting, I really wanted to have the Virgin stand apart from the background and be completely isolated. So she's almost like an anchor inside all of the chaos of the cracked and sanded background. So, you got the Botticelli painting. Also in the background, you got a gold leaf halo slash crown of thorns that's been sort of graffiti back there. Another thing you may not be able to see very well, but there's a take a close look. This is a very light poem that a pencil right here on the wall. It's a poem that's talking about wisdom slash Sophia, which is the apocryphal idea of, I don't know if you can call it like a female deity, it's the embodiment of wisdom. And so it's another reference to sort of like female as heroine, but also having been reviled in a lot of history, or not reviled, just sort of relegated to the sidelines. And then the central figure, you have the Virgin in a classic Christ deposition pose with the stigmata and her blue and white gown, which is the typical symbol of her. I used a woman who is of Italian descent. I really wouldn't have a sort of older woman play Mary, not one really young, spelled one who had a lot of paintings. I wanted to have someone who looked like she had some experience and some years. And found just by happenstance, I happened on somebody who would be perfect for it, and she obliged. Then we have the painting. It took about a month, about 3 weeks. I started at the beginning of August and I took a week off because I was out of town, and then I had to hustle and really get it finished in time for the show, but I was really happy with how it turned out and it was successful. So, what do you think? You have any questions?
Why
did you name Mary? Well, I wanted to the theme of the show is the sort of focusing on the female in art, and especially in religious art. I wanted to show that it's not only men that suffer, it's not only the Christ figure that suffers. Obviously, Mary, being the mother of Christ, suffers as well. And there's this, there's a long history of people of both genders having stigmata, and so it should be almost like an analog of any kind of female that is suffering, or may have been crucified at that time. And I think it just sort of throws that into relief to have her so tranquil, and so languid. And in a Christ-like pose, but flipping it and having it be a mirror.